Dakota Dome is a multi-sport, athletic-only facility. Houses all of USD's athletics things from basketball, football, track and field, volleyball, you name it. Benefits of it is that every sport can participate or at least practice without having to worry about the weather and wind or rain or snow and things of that nature. But more importantly, how it's turned over from our facilities crew and how it goes from basketball to track or something like that is really why it's successful. So allowing all the athletes to train and avoid the elements, be able to kind of do their thing on a day-to-day basis without having to change training based on what's going on outside or other sports is kind of the key to the success. People that can fit in the dome. We've got room in the student section for 2,000-ish kids, and then in addition to football games, that's where we get the most of our crowds. We have track meets, both college and high school. We've got basketball games as it's set up right now, and then we host basketball camps in the summer and football camp as well as farm show over Christmas break, where they bring in combines and tractors in here.
Most of the students know the Dome because of football games, which take place during the fall. And in fact, the Dome is one of the best facilities for football in South Dakota. However, the turf is taken out at the end of the fall season, which makes the Dome available for other sports. Swimming pool is another part of the Dome. The pool is home for Division 1 swimming team and their meets, but it is open for public several times a week as well. Behind the students' bleachers on the other side of the Dome, visitors can find volleyball court with capacity of 500 people. The court accommodates our incredibly successful volleyball team. Visitors can also see all conference titles that USD teams collected since 1922 on the wall over the volleyball court. Softball players don't have a field inside the dome. However, they have a batting cage right next to the volleyball court for practicing over the winter. The basketball stadium is situated in the middle of the main floor in a dome that bleaches for 1,500 students. On the other hand, during the fall season, they need to practice on their field under the volleyball court. Most of the teams have their own locker room. This particular belongs to the men's track and field team. The squad along with the girls' part also became dominant on the main floor every year after the turf is taken out. Track in a dome actually became a key ingredient of the program's success.
I think back in Division II, back when I first came in 84, 85, it was a great recruiting tool because there weren't a lot of facilities like this around. And I think it, once we hosted the national meets in 88, 89, 90, 91, and 93, those were the indoor Division II national meets, it kind of upgraded our expectations as a program. And then I just feel like the Dome was part of that expectation. And then I think since 93, we've had a pretty good run and had a lot of success with it. But, you know, it's been a phenomenal facility for football and for track and field, there's no doubt about it. We've survived without an outdoor track just because we had a really nice indoor track. That's changed now in Division I, where you really have to have nice facilities, you know, indoor and outdoor, to be able to compete with a lot of the other programs.
is our weight room. This is USD's weight room. It's about 4,000 square feet. We have 14 racks, 14 platforms. We have a three-bar system on our first couple racks. We service over 400 athletes per day. This is the facility where they come to get better. This is our sanctuary, and this is where we do all of our lifting, all of our squatting, power cleaning, deadlifting, bench pressing, the whole nine. Getting a new facility, it's going to be about 8,000 square feet, so double everything that we have here. 24 racks, 24 platforms, it's going to be a pretty nice facility.
I would say on average, the amount of athletes that come into the training room daily would be throughout the year, 60. Depends on what season we're in. During football season, we're a lot busier, so there can be anywhere from 80 to 100 athletes just throughout the day. And then in the afternoon, it gets a lot busier during rehabs, and then during the winter and spring, it slows down a little bit more, but there's always a fluctuation of athletes, but definitely can be upwards of 80 to 100 in one day. Come to the training room for multiple reasons, whether it be small injuries, they just need to get wrapped up, or when they have severe injuries for treatment, and then also after treatment, getting rehab to get back into play. So anything from prevention to treatment, rehab, and multiple various injuries.
In the offices of the Dome, there are about 30 offices for about 45 employees, from coaches to administration. One classroom that have three or four different classes every semester. The new building will include classes for kinesiology, physical therapy, and occupational therapy.
Over the years, the Dome has become element key to success for USD athletic teams, and although new facilities are on the way, the Dome will be the icon for USD Coyotes for many more years.